A very warm afternoon to one and all present over here. Myself, Pradnya Sulke. I'm a Forensic Science first year student from Government Institute of Forensic Science, Nagpur. Today, I am here with my paper titled Dating of Documents and Overview. Now, beginning with it, I would like to introduce the topic, what dating of document means. Dating of document in its simple terms means determining. Ma'am, can we move to next slide? Dating of document in its simple term means when the date, determining the date of document, when the document was formed or produced. Document dating techniques are based on two methodologies, that is the static approach and the dynamic approach. I will be discussing these two different approaches in coming sections. Now, when we talk about dating of documents, so there are two terminologies that one should be well acquainted to. The first is the absolute age and the second is the relative age. Absolute age is the actual age of the document itself, whereas the relative age is the age of a document related to some other document. Now, the question comes that why dating of document is important, in which cases it plays a key role. It is important in the cases where the document being disputed has a historical value and the age of document itself is disputed. And other than this, it assists in many other cases too. Dating of documents can be done through either paper analysis, ink analysis, printing ink analysis, toner analysis, watermark analysis. This is also a main that how watermarks are analyzed to date the documents. And other conventional method includes handwriting analysis, determination the sequence of intersecting lines, and also sometimes the particle analysis would also help to date the document, including the pollen analysis and the spore analysis. But among all this, dating through ink analysis is more prevalent. Now, moving to the next slide, I would like to discuss these two approaches. The first being the static approaches. Static approach. It focuses on the date of the production of the raw constituents, date of the production of the raw constituents of the paper or the ink, and when they first came into existence. That is when they were introduced into the market first. Now, this is done by three techniques. One is either through using the determining the dating tags or the time tags. Second is determining the chemical composition. And third is the determination of the elemental profiles. When we date documents using this static approach, there are two prerequisites. That is, the measured parameter, the first being the measured parameter should be invariable to time. That is, it should remain static. It should not change to the time factor. The second is that there should be the proper availability of the database so that our observed result, analyzed results could be compared to that of the available databases. Moving to the next, I would like to discuss these three methods: the dating through dating tags and time tags. Second is dating through chemical composition, and third is dating through determining the elemental composition. Dating through time tags. What time tags are? Some ink manufacturers add the dating tags or time tags into their ink, such as the fluorescent tags or rare earth metal tags. Identify the year in which they were manufactured. When we determine these tags, it will be easy to reach the manufacturer and thus could give the year of manufacturing. Second is dating of documents through determination of the chemical composition. This is also based on the fact that determining the chemical formula of an ink or a paper or a toner and using some analytical techniques such as FTIR, Raman spectroscopy. And other than this, we have many analytical techniques which would give the chemical composition of ink, paper or a toner. And when these observations are compared to that of available databases, it would be definitely assess that which component was introduced first into the ink formulation or a paper formulation. For example, copper, thalocyanine dyes and the pigments were first introduced into the blue ink in the year of 1954. So if we found this component in the document ink, then it is confirmed that this document definitely produced after 1954. There are no possibilities that this document could be produced before 1954. Then the third is the determination of the elemental profiles. The inks or the paper, starting with the inks, composed of some elements, which some elements are in abundance, whereas some elements are in trace quantity, where the concentration is specific to a particular time period. Thus, knowing the elemental profiles, elemental concentration would help in dating of documents. Now, moving to the next, let's move to the dynamic methods. Dynamic methods focuses the dating of documents through aging process. We study the aging process of inks or a paper or toners to get the document date, production of document, date of the production of document. Coming to the next slide, I would like to discuss, I'm going to discuss the aging process of inks, how the aging process of inks could help in determination of age. Ma'am, can we move to next slide? Ink aging, when ink is placed onto the paper, as we know that ink consists of several components, varnishes, additives, colorants, solvents, and also some modifiers to modify their properties. These inks, when they are placed onto the paper, there are several changes start commencing, such as evaporation of solvents, degradation of dyes, hardening and polymerization of resins, and many such other changes are evident. These changes are though affected by many external factors such as the storing conditions and the substrate in which the ink is placed, the type of the nature of paper. Thus, when we date document using the aging of ink, the experts should always keep in mind what are the conditions that are affecting the aging process. And there are several different analytical techniques through which we can determine these aging changes, such as ICP, GCMS, and depending upon which parameter we are studying. If we are studying evaporation of solvent, then different analytical techniques are used. If we are studying polymerization of resin, some different analytical techniques are used. Now, moving to the next, I would like to explain that how toner aging and paper aging helps in determination of dates. Paper aging, dating of paper, dating of document through paper aging is very less practiced because of the fact that it starts aging since after it is manufactured. It is immediately when it is manufactured, the paper starts aging. But since the chemo, there are some methods such as chemometric approaches are being produced to determine the dates of the document using paper aging. How toner aging helps in dating of documents. Toner also consists of different constituents. As in the inks, I said, there are several changes. In toners also, when they are placed into the paper, there are several changes that can be analyzed through magnetic viewers, pyrolysis coupled with that of the gas chromatography. And these techniques can be, then these observations can be then used that which, what changes occur at which age, and thus would definitely assist in determining the age of the document. Moving forward, I would like to discuss some case studies. I have mentioned two, but I would like to add some third case, the Rathod case, which was very positively solved by Deepak Khanda sir, which I heard about in one of the lecture conducted by our college, headed by Deepak Khanda sir. The case was such that the petition, that the litigation was filed against Mr. Rathod, that the land he is owing was given to him by the government in some year, about 1890s or some earlier years. And he also showed a document relating to this property deeds. And thus, when this document was given for document examination, it was found that the pen which was used, the ink which was used to sign the document was found to be of a pilot pen ink, which itself was introduced into the year 1980. So, Handa sir solved the case based on this, that how come the document is being signed by a ink which was not even discovered during the signing of document. This is how the document, dating document, assists in the prosecution or the solving the criminal cases. Now, moving forward, I would like to conclude my presentation with a statement that, as already said by Mohinder Singh sir, that dating of document is a very controversial and challenging area in the field of questioned documents. So, we have many diverse methods relating to this, which have their own sets of limitations and advantages too. And thus, there is a need so that in working in this field, so that new potential methods, the new absolute and ideal methods can be found to date the documents. Thank you, ma'am. These are my references.